40 years ago, Shiite Ayatollah Ruhollah Khomeini spearheaded a revolution that deposed the monarchy in Iran. In its place arose an Islamic Republic. A repressive theocracy had replaced an authoritarian monarchy. And almost overnight, Iran had been transformed from a crucial U.S. ally into a bitter opponent. Here are some of the key dates that led to the revolution. From 1941 to 1979, Mohammad Reza Shah Pahlavi, a close partner of the United States, had ruled Iran. He modernized Iran while forcefully suppressing dissent and political freedoms. The clergy opposed the Shah's social and economic reforms. Discontent grew until in 1978, anti-Shah demonstration spread across the mostly Shia country. Strikes and mass protests erupted, and accusations flew that the Shah was the U.S. puppet. Martial law was imposed. Cassette tapes of speeches by the 76-year-old Khomeini were smuggled into the country, fueling the unrest. Many Iranians took to their rooftops at night to shout Allahu Akbar, or God is great, to express their protest. On January 16, 1979, the Shah left Iran for what was officially a vacation. Many Iranians rejoiced with chants of "The Shah is gone." The man who'd ruled the country for 37 years would never return from exile, dying some 13 months later. On February 1st, a crowd of around 3 million people in Tehran welcomed Khomeini's return from 14 years of exile. Asked about his feelings, the Islamic revivalist famously gave a cryptic one-word answer: nothing. Finally, on February 11th, the revolutionaries declared victory after Iran's demoralized armed forces declared neutrality. The monarchy was suddenly gone. Deadly factionalism followed, but Khomeini held the upper hand. And in April, following a nationwide referendum, an Islamic Republic was officially proclaimed, eventually with Khomeini at its apex. Thousands of Shah-era officials and other Iranians would be executed following summary trials. Student revolutionaries would storm the U.S. embassy, taking dozens hostage. Tehran would doggedly pursue anti-Western policies for decades to come. The revolution's 40th anniversary arrives at a critical juncture for the Islamic Republic, hobbled by U.S. sanctions, infighting, and the frustration of a restless young populace, most of whom were born after the revolution. Some regime insiders have warned recently that the Islamic establishment could collapse. Even one of Khomeini's own grandsons warned there's no guarantee that the system his grandfather created would survive. Despite such speculation, it is clear that the clerical establishment remains firmly in place.